Study Arata. So what is andragogy? In order to answer this, let's first explore another question. Who learns more easily, adults or children? When we see a question like this one, we tend to answer that children are better at learning. After all, children have a younger brain. They absorb like a brand new sponge, whatever is taught to them. But why wouldn't you, as an adult, also have that ability? Well, science shows that you do. Adult education has been researched about within many fields of study, and one of the greatest researchers about this topic was Malcolm Knowles, who popularized the term andragogy. Just as pedagogy is the science that deals with child education, andragogy is the science of adult education. And there's some good news. Adults are as capable of learning as children are, and on top of that, they have some extra advantages. Adults have at least 5 extra advantages over children when it comes to learning. Malcolm Knowles concluded that there are 5 premises of adult education. And these are the 5 advantages that adults have that children don't have when they're learning. The first advantage is self-concept. Whilst most children are forced to learn a predefined set of subjects, adults are free to choose what they're going to be studying. Additionally, adults are also more able to make their own decisions and decide how, where, and when they're going to study. Advantage number 2 is the adult learner experience. Adults have already learned a lot of things in life, and that is why adults can use that experience to find shortcuts and learn faster. Adults can transfer ideas and concepts that they already know to other subjects and make analogies and learn new subjects that they're studying more effectively. The third advantage is their readiness to learn. Adults are more interested in learning about things that are related to real situations of their day-to-day, while children are forced to be studying abstract topics far removed from their everyday lives, while adults usually study subjects of their immediate interest. Advantage number 4 is their orientation to learn. Adults prioritize studying subjects that can be put into practice. This priority results in a learning focused on practical day-to-day problems. The 5th and last advantage is their own motivation to learn. When it is you who decides you're going to learn something, your intrinsic motivation is greater. And that is different from what happens with children who oftentimes depend on extrinsic motivating factors such as their grades, marks, and pep talks from their parents and teachers. Now let's return to the question that started this conversation. Who learns more easily, adults or children? Science is clear when you answer this question. Adults can learn as well as children. And adults have the extra advantages of being more autonomous, of having more experience and being ready and motivated to learn and apply what they learned. Let's say that you as an adult have already decided to learn something new and in order to enhance your career, or to improve in some aspect in your life, or simply to acquire a new ability. Well, you can be sure that you're able to learn anything as good as anyone else of any age, and you can use the principles of andragogy to your advantage. Learn in a participative, relevant, and practical way, experiencing what you learn. There are 4 basic principles of adult learning, and if you follow these 4 principles, you will get to learn anything you want in a faster, more fun, and more effective way. Initially, you have to involve yourself in the planning and evaluation of what you're going to be learning. We've already talked about the meta-learning map on episode 175 of the series Hello, Sage Arata. Malcolm Knowles calls this plan self-directed learning. Forget about delegating your learning process to others. When you're going to study something, don't make the mistake of simply doing a course. Don't let other people plan what you are going to learn and evaluate what you know. Instead of that, even before starting to study, just sit down and plan what you actually want to learn. What are your needs? How are you going to evaluate whether you are learning or not? When you do this meta-learning map, you're designing a study program targeted specifically to you. Only you can do that. The support of teachers and other education professionals is important, yes, but as an adult, you need to be in charge of your own learning. Secondly, you can't be afraid of experiences. Experiments provide the basis for your learning, and that includes the mistakes that you make when you do these experiments. For example, at the beginning, you may think that you're going to learn a new language attending classes on the internet. But after a few lessons, you realize that you are actually not learning anything. In that case, you can't get stuck on your mistake. You must try another solution until you find the best learning method for you. The third basic principle is that you learn more easily things that have to do with your day-to-day life. The bigger the impact and relevance of what you're studying, the better. And the fourth and last principle is directly linked to the third principle. This last principle of andragogy states that adult learning is more effective when it focuses on problem solving. This means that you don't need to first study the theory and then apply it in your life. Instead of that, it is better to take a practical problem that you're facing and see how you can solve it. The Andragogical Learning Flow comes with a script for you to learn more and better. Andragogy doesn't only deal with theories about how adults learn better. There are practical suggestions for you to apply to your life and increase your ability to learn. And one of those suggestions is the Andragogical Learning Flow, created as some kind of a script, a sequence of 5 steps that will help you to learn more effectively. The first step is having a good learning environment. A good learning environment is when your surroundings foster your studies. The environment doesn't only include your teachers, but also the materials you use, the physical or virtual course facilities, and even the people who learn with you. The second step is making a diagnosis of your needs. Why do you want to learn the things you want to learn? What is behind that desire? Is it some practical need for your work or to your personal life? Or is it a hidden desire? Is it out of vanity, perhaps? Besides the reasons why, you must also be clear about the what. What specifically do you want to learn? What topics would you need to master in order to reach these desired results? What does it mean to master all those topics? The third step is making your planning, your meta-learning map. Plan what you're going to study, when you're going to study. What materials you're going to use. The fourth step of the flow is conducting learning experiences. Adults learn better when they solve practical problems. So try to start solving problems, and whenever you find it hard, go back to the theory to solve that specific problem. And the fifth and last step is judging what you've learned. And that can be done by teachers, by practical results in exams and tests, by automated systems. The most important thing is that you evaluate whether what you learned is consistent with the results you expected to get in the planning phase. By following the Andragogical Learning Flow, you can gain abilities that will bring results into your life. Put andragogy into practice to make your professional, your personal life better. Learning how to learn is one of the most important abilities that any person can have, especially adults. Take a look at your biggest life objectives. Perhaps earning more money, or furthering your career, or buying a house, or having a better body shape, improving your relationships. Whatever your objective is, you can reach that goal in a faster and more effective way. You just need to learn how to overcome the obstacles that lie between you and your objective. Learning doesn't just mean sitting down with books to pass exams. You must see learning as a tool to deal with practical day-to-day problems, as a practical solution of your day-to-day problems. First of all, when you're designing the map of what you're going to study, you have to make sure that you know why you're studying each one of those subjects. Then, the study should be focused on practical tasks instead of just memorization. Memorization has its own place, and it has to be used in certain cases, but in adult learning, practice always prevails. Apart from that, the learning process must be carried out taking into account that every person is different. The materials and learning activities must be adapted to the learner, not the other way around. Last, the study must allow you to discover new knowledge on your own. Even though materials and teachers guide you and correct your mistakes, the ideal is that the ones you choose let you get to your own conclusions. Choose an environment that promotes adult learning. The chosen environment has a direct impact on how much you learn. The environment in which you study is extremely important for you, for your learning results. And when I say environments here, I'm talking about the materials you choose, the teachers, the platform of your online course, or the physical facilities in case of face-to-face courses. It is best to have an environment that supports your individual needs. If you are in a shared environment, it must respect the knowledge level and the skills of each individual. And that is why courses with a lot of students usually don't go very well, unless there is a more customized support for each student. The learning environment also has to value creativity and experience. So leave aside old-fashioned concepts like grades and the punishment and mockery of mistakes. The environment must value each adult as an individual worthy of respect and honor for being in search of learning new things. And besides that, it is recommended that the environment promotes self-directed learning. Teachers and courses and materials, all the factors involved should co-create the lessons together with the adult learners. You know you are in a good learning environment when you realize that your level of intellectual skills is being challenged. The learning can be neither too easy as to not develop boredom, nor too difficult as not to foster giving up. And finally, the environment must give constant and precise feedback about your progress. The best thing is getting quick feedback about each phase of the learning process so that you feel that you're actually advancing and moving forward. The results of Andragogy can turn you into a better person, and better people build a better society. The formal education system has as one of its main goals to train people to be productive and contribute to society. These people are citizens' governors, which means people who understand their role in society. People who don't just keep waiting for the government to solve their own problems, but who act in practice to create a better society. There are 7 desired results of adult education. The first one is that the adult who studies will gain self-knowledge. These people will understand their needs and their motivation and their interests. And this leads them to personal development and to self-respect. And beyond that, adults with better education are better citizens. They learn to respect different opinions, to have empathy, to help people in need. Better citizens have a more positive, more fluid, and dynamic attitude towards life. That brings them to positive attitudes such as resilience, acceptance of changes, and the identification of learning opportunities. Andragogy also leads to a greater clarity to discern symptoms and causes. An adult who knows how to treat the causes goes straight to the root of the problems. But the people who never learn how to learn can spend their whole lives treating symptoms, putting out fires, and carrying water to the sea. When you become a learning adult, you gain more clarity about your own personality. You begin to identify which are your strengths and which are your weaknesses. Education helps you to have a better balance and reach your full potential. The greater your ability to learn, the better your understanding of the human nature as a whole, and you will be more clear about what your personal values are. And you will also understand that different people value different things. And the better you know about human nature, the more capable you become of contributing to make positive changes in society. And that is why Andragogy is able to transform not just your own life, but the lives of everyone around you. Andragogy is the art and the science of adult education. As an adult, you can learn as good as a child, or even better. Regardless of what your life goals are, you can reach them all more easily if you have the ability to learn how to learn. Adults who are able to acquire new knowledge are more likely to find better jobs, higher salaries, and a more satisfying life as a whole. Arata Academy has always been focused on adult education and is now launching a new training program aimed to enhance your intelligence, your memory, your ability to learn. And you can check out this new intelligence course by going here to arata.se/intelligence.